Milkfish, a flash of silvery lightning in the sea, is the number one fish species in Taiwan. Tainan is the most important area in Taiwan for the farming, processing, producing, and selling of milkfish. In terms of production volume, quality, and the reputation of milkfish cuisine, Tainan is second to none. Such a great achievement is credited with relentless efforts made by generations of people and families. Tidal flats have always been the lands where the poor start from scratch. In the 17th century, this area was still covered by the sea and belonged to Taijiang Lagoon. North to Jiangjun, south to Jieding, and east to Jiali and Yongkang, Taijiang Lagoon once covered an extensive area. Both trade and inshore fishing were thriving at Anping Port. In 1823, however, a violent summer rainstorm caused the diversion of Zengwan River. A large amount of silt formed new tidal flats. The look of Taijiang area has therefore gradually changed. Waves get born on April 24th and open eyes on April 26th. This is an old saying that goes around south of Tainan. The water gate separates the pond and the ditch. As the tide rises, clean seawater can flow into the pond through the opened water gate. Now, fish farmers can buy artificially bred fish fry easily. But in previous days, when artificially bred fish fry were unable to meet the market demand, they had to collect wild fry in the sea. Amid the profound beauty of the sea, Taijiang inhabitants make a living by fishing, fish farming, and salt pans. Mr. Chun creates artwork inspired by Taijiang's fish farms, including the fishing village and surrounding natural scenes, reflecting the characteristics of Taijiang. When local fry were not enough, some were imported from other countries, like the Philippines. Mr. Chou Xiuxiong, an 80-year-old fish farmer living in Dujia, still has vivid memories of the fry transport process in his early years.
I 十分钟前哦，这个壳蛋打哦，这块做壳蛋，打哦，水这就安尼渗，啊渗了哦，这就有一个水出来，有沙甲用的水出来，有水出来就有上锁，安尼打，啊你爱撩来走，未使停着，爱来切安尼撩来走。
Mr. Cho had to set off before dawn in order to put fry into the pond earlier.
This is a big one. This is a big one. This is a big one. I'm going to go to this 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 one. I'm going
In 1982, Taiwan broke the world record of breeding large quantities of milkfish fry successively. Simply as a fish farmer, Mr. Lin Liatong stunned the fish farming industry all over the world.
So, in 1982, the artificial fish farming industry in Taiwan broke the world record of breeding large quantities of 养成功的原来上个多礼拜，就有13266位。我文献发表，13266位是国际演出十美里边最成功的一次啊，成绩最好的一次啊。
In 1985, Mr. Lin successfully developed the technique to make milkfish spawn naturally in fish ponds, and this has turned Taiwan from a fry importer to a fry exporter.Due to considerable operating costs and high risks, fish farming has taken steps towards capitalization and specialization. Firstly, the pond owner will hire an experienced chief. The chief is just like a CEO in a company and has to take charge of the entire operation. Under the chief, there are also a bookkeeper, a watergate controller,several general workers, cooks, and trainees. At the fry farm in Jiadong, we can see younger people weave their way through the fish ponds. Mr. Li Kun Liang is the third generation in his family that operates the fry farm. His work is to grow tiny fish fry into 15-centimeter juvenile fish,before selling them to other fish farms. Growing up at fish ponds, Mr. Li has learned to solve problems by asking more, listening more, and trying more.
One is 4,000, and one is 33,000. We usually fish 5,000. This is 浅平市粗放饲养池, so the fish is bigger and bigger, and the fish is more充足.
The fry raised at fry farms are sold in different sizes according to the requests of buyers. At 3 a.m.A skillful fish farmer and his partners are ready for work in dim light. They are racing against time to guide the fry into the ditch before dawn for the convenience of the following catching work. Engaged in milkfish farming for over 60 years, Uncle River still takes part in the catching and selling work in person as usual.Each fry represents not only his effort, but also fish farmers' wealth. Screening out fish fry by size is also an important technique. The fish farmer uses a hemispherical iron sieve to screen out the fry. The fry which can pass through the sieve will be counted. With so many fish fry swimming around, How can fish farmers figure out the correct number of hundreds of thousands of fry within a morning? Fish farmers will sing as they count in order to remember the numbers and gain credibility. Usually, the counter puts a plastic stick to mark every 100 fry. The counting process brought about many special counting methods, but they are vanishing due to the low price of fry nowadays. To Mr. Chun, the simple plain scenes are pure beauty without decoration. He uses his special techniques to arrange space, focus, and distance. By doing so, viewers can see the whole scene from near focus. Milkfish is a urohaline species living in tropical and subtropical regions. They grow the fastest in summer, but unstable weather conditions pose great challenges to fish farmers. Here is National University of Tainan Chigu campus. Mr. Zhou Fengzai is the administrator of this experimental fish pond, which adopts shallow water farming. He released fry into the pond in April, and after half a year, each fish has grown to over 0.3 kilograms. It's still sweltering on this summer evening. At 11 p.m., Joe goes to check the fish pond for the second time. His anxiety does not come from nowhere. Unlike typical fish ponds, this pond is not installed with a water wheel, so he should be more cautious and diligent. Taiwan's aquaculture industry started from milkfish farming. However, restricted by the water depth and the amount of algae, shallow water farming was unable to yield large harvests. In 1980, the fad of tiger prawn farming swept through Taiwan and appealed to many fish farmers. The raging virus, unfortunately, doomed the prawn farming industry in 1990. Prawn farmers turned back to their former career as milkfish or grouper farmers. However, the ponds were difficult to restore to their original state. This therefore brought deep water fish farming into being, and the high productivity even pushed forward the milkfish processing industry.
民国80年代以后, 深度的养殖 渐渐愈来愈多，这个深度养殖呢，因为伊单位面积的产量足大，差不多是千坪养殖的要几十倍，所以伊的经营形态、养殖的形态，规拢改变。
With meticulous care in summer, fish farmers are about to greet the harvest season. 2 hours before catching the fish, let's have some thrills we can ride a motorboat to sail around the pond. The scared fish will excrete. The process can make the fish cleaner. It's called xiao dou. The show of catching the milkfish happens 3 times a day in Taijiang. Workers drag the fishnet together from 2 sides. Fish that reach a certain size will be kept. Others will be driven to the winter pond to get through winter. This is the end of a year's fish farming cycle. Will be classified according to size. Then workers add some ice to the basket and send them to fish markets in the north, retail markets, or fish factories in the south. The whole milkfish can be utilized except the gills. The fish will be segmented to different parts. The most valuable part is the fish belly, which will be taken first. Fish back and other parts can be made into dried fish floss or fish balls. Sometimes the fish will be made into fish cans, seasoned with local tomatoes. The food miles can therefore be reduced. In Taiwan, milkfish represents the combination of seasonal flavor and food culture. In Tainan, it's the most common fish on the dinner table. The memory of milkfish accompanies the people of Tainan their whole lives. There are many great milkfish restaurants hidden in Tainan. Many people look forward to satisfying their empty stomachs with milkfish in the morning. That warms both their stomachs and hearts. As the saying goes, the typhoon may strike in September with no trace. Fish farmers can only watch the rising water with fear. Please, don't cause the fish ponds to flood over. Mr. Huang Guoliang used to work in the technology field. 7 years ago, he decided to go back to Beimen to realize his dream. A son who came home to take care of his old lonely father, he retains a strong sense of pride. He insists on not catching fish with an electrical shock, but with a net.
Yes. 所以我们就使用这一种网距比较大的流丝网，大只的留下来，小只的我们就让它再跑走这样子。最主要我是希望在鱼体不经过电击的状况之下哈，让它能呈现它最原始的丝木鱼的风味。啊，其实我们不是把这只鱼变好吃，我只是让它回到过去而已。
In recent years, the idea of eco-friendly fish farming has attracted more and more fish farmers, like Qiu Jingyao and Qiu Jiancheng. They insist on farming fish from fry to mature fish and have full control of the quality.
那社员来到我们这边就是让他了解产地，了解我们的想法，然后其实眼见为凭的力量也很重要，你看到的跟你吃的有所连结之后，你会一个比较深层次的依赖感、信赖感。
Adopting low density and eco-friendly farming, the brothers take care of the ecosystem first, so the creatures can grow in a natural way. This is how they treat their fish ponds.
因为养鱼要先养水，养水要先养土。在这样的水封闭性的水塘环境里面，还有其他各式各样的物种。那当这些鱼虾跟这些物种在里面，是不是能够平衡、很稳定的成为一个生态系？这个池水才会是健康的。那我们这些鱼虾在里面才会健康，才会快乐。
When blackface spoonbills are protected, other waterfowl and wildlife are protected as well.The pond is used to farm fish for half a year and shelter waterfowl for the other half. By doing so, the wetland can strike a balance. After harvest, fish farmers still have work to do. They have to flatten the bottom of fish ponds with scrapers and expose it to the sun to eliminate germs and wild fish. In the beginning of spring,Fish farmers will spread rice bran into fish ponds and refill them with some seawater. After the rice bran is fully fermented, the ponds will be dried again by the sun. When Qingming comes, seawater is guided into fish ponds. Fish fry can feed on the algae at the bottom. Fish farmers know that a great harvest is the reward given by God for their hard work. Going through the unstable weather in spring,The extreme heat in summer and the destruction of typhoons. These fish cannot be harvested without meticulous care.
In fact, fish farming on this land is a circular farming. For this land, there is no burden on this land. You can
ask for your life, you can ask for your life. If you don't have your life, you can ask for your life.
这个理念讲，要让人吃到会放心，啊，你后边啊鱼三百鱼卡，剩卡侪人会想要去吃啦。
Taijiang, a wonderland full of stories, fascinating views, and great flavors, is beautiful in all aspects. As spring comes, blackface spoonbills put on their breeding plumage.Ready to go back to the north. And the productive fishing towns keep nourishing both old and young fish farmers for generations. The harmonious coexistence among humans, fish, and birds creates a sustainable environment. We truly hope that the glittering milkfish can make the black-faced spoonbills thrive forever in Taijiang.
时间内底收，一只海鸥，当时会搁拍脚掌。咱咱甜甜笑笑，臭情的台江人，拼过寒冬的鱼仔，一碗饭过一碗。北风、南风、咸风，吹入海海的港。无用 山的云仔花，一领一领的希望。